which of the following provisions of the constitution can be amended, okay, means it means you can change by a majority of members of each house present and voting. What does it mean, majority of members each house present and voting? Means it means simple majority, okay. What does it mean, simple majority, okay. So if you are making changes through the constitution through a simple majority, can we call it as constitutional amendment? No. See, constitution, the term constitutional amendment is clearly prescribed under Article 368, which says that both the houses have to pass it by two-third majority. What is that majority? Special majority, two-third members of present and voting. So majority of members present and voting means there are some simple majority. Okay, see, so constitution can be, you can make changes to the constitution, okay. You can make changes to the constitution through simple majority also, through special majority also. When we use it special majority only, we require a constitutional amendment act. Otherwise, it is a general, so the parliament can ease. So in some cases, clearly, the parliament can make changes to the constitution with a simple majority. For example, when we studied union and territory, okay, regarding creation of new state, you don't require, you have to, for creation of new state, you don't require a special majority. It can be done through a simple majority. There are cases in which, there are many cases in which the parliament can make changes to the constitution through simple majority. Okay, they are asking for it. Okay. So, regarding the establishment of new state, do we require a special majority? No, we require only a simple majority. So, first is correct. First is a correct statement. Okay. So, we can eliminate. What about second schedule? What is second schedule regarding what is their emoluments? Okay. So for that, to changing the second schedule, you require only simple majority. For changing the second schedule also, you require only simple majority. So, 2 is also correct. So, 2 should be there in the answer. So, from this, we get to know. So, answer will be either C or D. So, you get to know that automatically 4 will be correct. If you know 1 and 2, 4 is correct. Now, we have to find out third one. What is there in the 7th schedule? Unionless. It is actually this power between the union and the, so the, how the power is divided, okay, between the union states is clearly mentioned in the 7th schedule. And if you want to make any changes to this federal, actually it affects the federal system, okay. If you want to make any changes to the 7th schedule, you require constitutional amendment. You require constitutional amendment. So, simple majority will not work in order to amend 7th schedule. If you want to make changes to 7th schedule, you require special majority and under Article 368, okay. And one more important thing regarding this 7th schedule is that, okay, have a clear cut idea regarding the constitutional amendment, okay. See, I'm talking about, see, generally when you do it through a simple majority, we don't require a constitutional amendment bill, okay. Now, constitutional amendment, there are two types of constitutional amendment is there. One is a special majority. One is a special majority of two-third members present and voting. Okay. So, both the houses have to pass under which article? Under Article 368. Okay. Two-third members present and voting. Okay. But, if the constitution is going to amend anything which affects our federal system, keep this in mind. Okay. If any provisions which affects our federal system, okay, this not only sufficient, okay, you require, along with the passage of both the houses of parliament, it require half of the state legislature approval. An important point to note down, okay. If the parliament is going to make any changes, if the parliament is going to, will study, actually that is mentioned under Article 368. If the parliament is going to make any constitution, for example, GST, you know that, na, GST council was created, or this GST, for GST we have a constitutional amendment bill, that we have a constitutional amendment act, okay. To introduce GST, goods and service tax, we required a constitutional amendment. Now, what is the specialty of GST? GST affects our federal features. How? It affects the financial distribution, financial division, financial power distribution between the center and states, okay. So, before introducing the GST, we came up, means the parliament have passed a GST bill, constitutional amendment bill. So, both the houses passed with a special majority, and Once half of the state legislature approved it, only GST constitutional amendment came into force. And after that, then the center have passed GST law. That is different, okay? So regarding the GST constitutional amendment, okay? The GST constitutional amendment, very, very, very important, okay? So keep this in mind. So if you are amending the constitution and that amendment affects federal features, this normal two-third majority is not sufficient. It require half only. Half of the, just keep it in mind, half of the state legislature, okay? So now currently how many states we are having? 28. So half means 15 states, current strength, 15. Okay, so please, so 7th schedule affects the federal feature. So it not only require two-third majority, it require half of the state legislature approval also. So answer is C, 1, 2 and 4. And even GST council have made changes to, once we introduced GST council, GST Act, okay, constitutional amendment have made changes to 7th schedule also.